Welcome back to latest TV news. I'm joined now by NHS midwife Laura Spicer, here to talk about World Continence Week, which launched earlier this week. So I guess this is all about awareness, but it's particularly around awareness around women's problems around continence. And I, speaking for myself personally, and I think perhaps generally, there might be a lot of stigma around this, a very difficult subject to talk about and could be an embarrassing subject. But also, I guess, we might associate it mainly with the elderly, but this is a problem for a lot of women that have had babies, isn't it? And also menopausal.
Yeah, absolutely. Young women have suffered with stress incontinence for such a long time now. And also menopausal women also have the symptoms. And there is a lot out there that the NHS can offer, as well as other private treatments. But we generally recommend getting your pelvic floor exercises done properly, getting them assessed, making sure that you're actually physically doing it properly. I reckon about 80% of the women that I see and examine aren't doing their exercises properly anyway to start with.
So the pelvic floor exercise, is that something that is whilst you're pregnant? Is that something that's encouraged whilst you're pregnant post-baby?
Yeah, ideally you should be doing it even before you have children. So all women should be aware of their pelvic floor muscles and how to tone them and support them, ready for if they ever do or go on to have children.
Mm. I've never had a baby, but I do my pelvic floor exercises. So you mentioned the support out there. So I guess, like anything, this would be a referral to your local GP. Firstly, very important to sort of, you know, get past that stigma and that embarrassment, speak to your GP, and then what kind of services can you offer?
So the NHS will offer a women's physio, so they, again, will examine the woman and just make sure that she's doing her pelvic floor exercises properly. There's lots of radical treatments out there, lots of new treatments. There's laser treatments, when they laser the urethra and the vagina, which helps stop that stress incontinence.
Okay, so this is something you sort of want to get the message out loud and clear this week. It's all about sort of the awareness around
it. Absolutely. Women just hide it, and they keep those symptoms quiet, whereas in actual fact they should be talking to each other and kicking up more of a stink. You know, women shouldn't have to put up with this at such a young age, to suffer with stress incontinence for the rest of their lives.
Okay, and any sort of recommendations as to where people could find out more information? Would it be best to sort of go to an NHS website?
Yeah, you can go to the NHS website, and also you can Google vagina laser treatments, and you'll get the results you're looking for.
Okay. Laura, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Thank you.